I found out during lockdown that my husband has a girlfriend.
COVID-19 to me is defined by my partner of 9 years leaving me during Melbourne's stage 4 lockdown restrictions.
Lockdown has put a big strain on my marriage.
E a pandemia não poupou em nada, assim, né?
Quando eu vi a Rafaela, alguma coisa já bateu bem rápido, sim.
Eu achei ele muito gentil, né?
She lit up a room. She was just magical. I think that's the best way I can explain it.
Ours was an arranged marriage in just nine days. To be honest, the relationship didn't flourish.
We married a few years ago. He was always very sweet and caring. And everything was okay until 2020. My husband doesn't know I'm talking about this now. That's why I can't show my real face.
Eu achava ela muito bonita, lógico.
E foram 12 anos bonitos, assim, a maior parte dele.
Lots of therapists are reporting a real demand for couples therapy and relationship therapy at the moment. Our work lives are under pressure, our family lives are under pressure, and we're just trying to hold it all together. One of the biggest things that couples are describing is just kind of not getting on, or higher levels of conflict. There's also, on the intimacy side of things, a real impact on desire and couples finding space and time to be together intimately.
Because we were in lockdown and it was limiting in what we could do and couldn't do, we entered this like routine funk. It just led to the pain points in our relationship just intensifying.
E assim, a gente passou a brigar por coisas fúteis, né? Por coisas sem importância.
Mm-hmm. Trouble started after the lockdown began. I went through his phone and I found out he has a girlfriend. I confronted him, and all he kept saying was, how did you get into my phone? It was a big blowout.
A pandemia veio escancarar uma convivência 24 horas por dia com duas crianças dentro de casa e trabalho home office. E muita coisa passou a não convergir mais, né?
I think he had told his girlfriend that he wanted to divorce. Because his girlfriend said, if you want to divorce your wife, don't sleep in the same room or eat your wife's food. She could poison you.
It just went down really quickly. You know, she was gone, and I just felt so alone.
Being in the same space, parenting, working, coupling, has meant that there is nowhere to hide. So the habits that we find kind of normally irritate us a bit but don't drive us that crazy are really obvious. Trying to move away from criticizing or blaming our partners is really important, and we can get really stuck in a cycle. So using I statements, so my feelings are, I'm feeling, rather than you do this, you make me feel.
I think lockdown fast-tracked the expiry date. I got to a point where I got really down, and then I just cried my eyes out.
Hey, a pandemia, ela acelerou, né, o processo. Sim. Fez com que a gente enfrentasse o problema e não fugisse dele, né, com coragem, resignação.
I will call my parents and cry. But my parents are Christians. They don't believe in divorce or separation. They told me stay there, no matter what your husband does. To be really honest, it's going to take a long while for love to come back.
I just want to be like a normal couple. I do feel lonely, yeah. I don't have a solution right now, and I don't know how to solve it.
Não era que eu queria separar, mas não vi outra alternativa, assim, porque eu vi que a gente estava mantendo uma relação tóxica, assim, um pro outro. Eu acho que somos duas pessoas muito legais, assim. Eu acho que os dois merecem muito ser felizes.
While this hurts like hell, I think we outgrew one another. But I think that it just went down in a really traumatizing way because of lockdown, because of COVID-19.
It's a really difficult time to go through a breakup. So for people who've gone through breakups in lockdown, it's really important that you reach out to the people that you're close to, reach out to the people that you love. It's also really important that you do the things that make you feel good about yourself, just for you. So practicing a lot of self-care.
Each day is getting better, but then you still have those days that are awful. And you know what? It's very similar to this whole COVID-19 situation. You've got to maintain the hope that, you know, this will be okay.
Não era o que eu queria, mas já que nós decidimos assim, que a gente possa ser bastante feliz. Tá bom?
Seremos.